there's going to be a component of shortening, of profit, right? Convergence of profit, and that comes into play later. So here's a land mathematic mapper in this false color of southern Haiti with the Emmerichio fault on it, and if you can find it before I put the arrows up. There are the arrows that show it cutting across the landscape, right in through here, like this, and across through here, goes offshore where the epicenter actually was, and then back on shore through here. Very easy to see. Evidently, there are really large crocs out in the lake. Never did, so I don't. So here Google Images looking west from Port-au-Prince. This is Port-au-Prince. You can see the fault cutting through the mountain, and here is the fault again, which is back in here. Now, you can tell just by looking at this that it can't purely strike slip. If it were purely strike slip, why would we have these huge mountains? If you were just having motion side to side, then there would be no reason to push anything up. So the fact that there are large mountains tells us that it can't be purely strike slip. Okay, so now we'll go to seismicity in Hawaii. The last major earthquake on any fault segment happened about 150 years ago. The last earthquake on the segment of the Emmerichio fault that ruptured in January was in 1751. Recent seismicity was very weak. Okay, I showed you that picture. Relative to other areas of the globe. So this gave the Haitians, and in fact most of the Northern Caribbean, a false sense of security that earthquakes were not relevant to them. Okay? There was no memory of people. So here's a brief aside when you look at Chile, and this shows you where faults, where significant earthquakes happened, and where the ruptures were. 1960 is the largest earthquake on record in the era of modern instrumentation. And you can see they happen all the time. 13, I guess 14, no, they revised it from 7.2 to 6.9 this afternoon. So still 13, greater than 7.0. As I said, the largest ever reported by modern instruments, 9.5 in 1960. And Chile has a lot of money relative to Haiti, which results in an educated population, good building codes and planning. Okay, so that's the other reason why the destruction in Haiti wasn't so much. All right. So what science told us in Haiti? The faults have seismicity. We knew they had seismicity. They'd been having earthquakes, although they were small. The historical record reveals major events in the past. I'm talking pre-modern instrumentation, but historical accounts tells us there have been major events in the past. Then the GPS geodetic results, which I will talk about in a second, indicate that there has been strain accumulating on the fault measurement. Okay. So when we put all of this information together, especially this last little bit, which was based on the GPS geodesy, this is what led to this so-called prediction. So here's the paper. Okay, so here's me. You can see, here's me, the student. And you can see that it's a paper. It's like an innocuous paper. It doesn't say we predict a really big earthquake on the Emmerichio fault in the title. Here's the abstract. This is a paper. And here is the sentence in the paper that says, similarly, the Emmerichio fault in Hawaii is Haiti is currently capable of a magnitude 7.2 earthquake if the entire lapse of strain accumulated since the last major earthquake, the one in 1751, was released in a single event today. So that's what he said. And this was in 2008. And Eric Clay, who's my colleague here at Purdue University, did talk to the Haitian government and told them they needed to be aware of this and they needed to have emergency management planning and thinking about reinforcing the buildings and so forth. All right, so I said seismicity was weak, but it was there. Here's the map that shows the earthquakes. And you can see there have been earthquakes. This is 1964 to 2010, but the largest have only been, you can see here's a circle, maybe magnitude.